Hey everyone, Jason here, certified Canva creator, and in this Canva 2.0 tutorial, we're going to be going through 5 different opt-in gifts you can make using Canva 2.0. Timestamp table of contents in the description, of course. We're going to be going through some examples and then 5 different ideas you can use Canva to create your own opt-in gifts. But before we dive into those 5 and all those examples, there are 3 keys to success when it comes to designing your opt-in gifts to grow your email list. The first key to success is making sure that whatever information you're putting inside your opt-in offer is it's valuable and actionable. Now, the second key to success is making sure that you not only focus on the value of content you're delivering inside of your opt-in gift, but you're also focused on how you deliver that. And that's the design, because when it comes to your lead magnets or your opt-in gifts, your opt-in offers, this is the first time that someone is engaging with you and your brand. They've taken a big step by providing their contact information. So make sure that the information you're delivering is not only valuable and actionable, but it's presented in a good-looking way. And that leads me into the third key to success when it comes to designing your opt-in offers, and that is you either want them to have an aha moment, so they have a quick win, or you want to have them have a, oh wow, this is a crazy amount of work moment, because both of them are going to help you in your sales process to sell your product or service. I'm going to go through what both of these can look like as we dive into designing your opt-in offer. So with that, let's go ahead and jump into my screen. I'll walk you through some examples of what I've designed in the past, and then we'll go through those 5. Now, inside of Canva on the homepage, we can click Browse All right here, and you'll see all of the different templates that we have available to us. So I'm gonna scroll down and tell you which templates you should be focused on when it comes to designing your opt-in gift. You want to look at presentation 16:9. You want to check out the report, and then we'll scroll over here. And you'll also want to take a look at the daily report. The reason that you want to click on all of these is because they all have different templates inside of them. So if we scroll down to personal here, we actually don't want planner, but if we come over here to book cover, this is a great place to find what the design of your cover for your opt-in gift is going to look like. And what's cool is you can actually move designs across different canvases. So if you find something cool in the book cover and something else in the proposal, you can actually combine those now using Canva 2.0. Scrolling down here, if you're putting together any sort of worksheet, audit, assessment, which we'll get into later, you can check out the worksheet and lesson plan templates as well. And so that pretty much does it for the templates to look at. Of course, you can click around and try other ones, but now what I want to do is go through some examples. So here's an example of a previous opt-in gift that I've made talking about video marketing and how to be successful with video marketing. So I'm just going to scroll down these pages so you can see, kind of get some ideas for yourself of how you can design the page. And I'm actually going to go click by click, creating 5 different opt-in offers here in a moment. This next one is an example of a opt-in offer that's more like a worksheet or a how-to guide. So you can see here the first part, we have a little diagram. Diagrams are great to create in Canva. And then it goes through each step of the process, helping them figure out what to put on their landing page, what to put on their thank you page, and how to put together their entire sales funnel. So you can see here, there's not a whole lot going on the actual content pages. What's really gonna take up the majority of your time is putting together this first page, and if you're going to be making any diagrams. So I'm just going through all of these to give you some ideas. The only purpose of this part of this tutorial is to just spark some ideas for you. So this next one is one that I've actually created in a previous Canva tutorial in Canva 1.0. And what I really like doing with some of the lesson pages is just having a basic element at the bottom that's a rectangle with a link to my site. Of course, you can actually hyperlink up here if you click on this little guy, and you can put in your URL, which is great, especially if you want to link to your sales pages while you're going through and creating your opt-in offers. And then, of course, having a combination of text and diagrams. Both of these, well, this one was created in Canva. This bottom one was created in Google Drawings, which is something you can use, but it takes a lot longer to put things together in Google Drawings. So I like Canva more for that. So here's another example of a goal setting one, and this is another presentation template. Again, I'm just scrolling through these to help spark some ideas before we go click by click. This particular one, I took some of the line elements and I just put them on the bottom and the left-hand side of the page. And then I just used a small rectangle to house the name of the opt-in offer. And so you can scroll down here and you can see how this looks like with text filled in. Here's an example of what a worksheet could look like. You see, we just have places for them to fill in the blank. And it really doesn't have to be super fancy. So we'll go to these last ones here real quick. So here's one where all we did was take a giant square and made it cover the top and then dropped an image here on the bottom. And here's another template design that I really like doing for the content pages. I just have a rectangle and then the page number, and then I have text boxes with a little logo at the bottom. So this last one I want to show you is an example of one where we're trying to overwhelm the prospect, right? So when someone opts into our list, we actually give them a ton of information about what's wrong with their Google Analytics, how to fix their Google Analytics. And the point here is to make sure that we're delivering all the information they need if they still want to go do it on their own. But at the same time, it does give them a sense of, wow, this is actually a lot of work. It might make sense to hire these guys. So now I'm going to go back home to Canva and I'm actually going to put together one from scratch. So in this particular video, we're going to be going over 5 different opt-in gift ideas. We're going to be doing how-to, we're going to be doing templates, we're going to do a resources list, a worksheet, and then a assessment. So we're gonna build all 5 of those right now. Remember, timestamp table of contents in the description if you want to skip ahead. So the first type we have is how-to. And this could be a cheat sheet, a blueprint, a quick start guide, or hacker's guide to. Essentially what we're doing here is we're just giving them the steps to be successful. So that's what we're going to build right now. So let's go ahead, jump back into Canva here, and I am going to scroll up and use the report template here for this particular how-to guide. So the first thing we need, of course, is a cover page. And if we scroll down here, you can see there are a lot of different templates that they have. It will always tell you whether it's free or not. Most of these actually are free. And even the ones that aren't, you can actually just remove the paid elements if you like the general design. So I'm just gonna scroll through here and find one that I like. And I'm going to click on this collection because it has a couple. So we can actually use all 3 of these templates to really quickly put together our opt-in gift. So I'll go ahead and click to bring it up to our canvas, and then I'll immediately change it to our brand colors. What's cool about Canva is you can save your brand colors, and I'm gonna change this to white. You can always come up here and click to change the color. Here we go, white. And adjust everything else to our brand colors. So now it's time to give this a title. Let's say we're doing a how-to guide on goal setting. So we're going to call this Goals 102, make this a little bigger so we can house more of the letters and slap our name on it. All right, cool. So now it's ready for the table of contents. So again, we'd go ahead and move all of the colors over to what we want to do for our brand. And then of course we would change this page based upon how many steps in the process there would be. So if we're doing a how-to, it'd probably be step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so we change up those numbers. I won't spend our time changing those because I know you guys know how to change that up. And we go ahead and click on our content page. So again, we change all of the colors to our brand color here, which we're going to change everything to blue. And then here's where we can start putting in our actual information. Now what's cool with a how-to guide is you don't necessarily have to change up this template very much. What I would recommend doing though is changing up this image for each page of content that we have. So what's cool is we can go over here to elements and we can actually search for different types of photos for free. You can go to a site like Unsplash, Pixabay, or Pexels.com to find other photos, but there are a lot of free ones in here. So if we're doing goal setting, all we can do is just come in here and type in goals and see what we get. It's important that you do very broad searches with Canva. And here we have a couple free, actually let's go to photos because we're looking for a photo and we'll see what comes up for free. So we have a couple of free ones. Let's try this guy. So we'll click and drag and then we can click and pull it in and then we can click on it and change where the cropping is and click done. And now we have our new page for goal setting. So maybe this is page one. So once you're happy with what you're looking at here, you can go ahead and copy the page. And then for the next part, maybe we're going to be talking about writing goals, right? So we can click and drag that one in there. And then we can copy the page again, and we'll pull in this last image, right? So I'll just click and drag, bring that over here. There we go. Keep the tiny humans alive. Great. So now, as you can see, we've put together a relatively good looking opt-in gift. We have our title page, we have our table of contents. It's going to walk us through step 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 for our how-to step-by-step guide. And then each page, really all we need to do is change up this side image, and we have a great looking opt-in offer ready to go. So that's all there is to it, to creating the opt-in offer number 1 of 5 here, and that's how to. Now the next one I want to talk about is the done for you template. So this is where you provide some scripts or a personal vault of information you have. It could be a case study, or it could be a collection of images, because this is Canva, you could make a collection of images, or in this instance, what we're going to do is a series of copywriting formulas. So let's jump on back over to Canva here. I'll do a different design this time. Let's scroll up and try a, well, I shouldn't say scroll up. Let's go to the right and try a presentation. So in this particular one, we're doing a done-for-you template. So I'm going to put together a done-for-you template for writing copy for a landing page. So this will be a series of headline formulas. So we can see, you can see here again, we have a bunch of different groupings of templates that we can choose from. I'm going to go to advertising because we're doing something about landing pages. And then of course, again, just scroll through, see which one you think looks the best. I'm going to go a little faster on this one. I'm going to click this guy. I'm going to change the colors this time. So fast forward to all the colors changed to the proper brand colors. And just like that, we've changed all of the colors to match what our particular company is. I've changed it, ACT Marketing Presents Headline Formulas by Jason, and this is looking a little plain. So let's come over here and look for a icon. So I can search for keyword formula. I click on graphics, and we'll want to look for a free one here. We're getting Formula One cars. That's funny. And we'll go ahead and click on this one. So I'm using Canva for work, so I can use the these ones for free. And we'll make it a little smaller and bring it over right about there. Perfect. So headline formulas, and I probably actually drag this up a little bit just so there's a little more space there. And just like that, we have the title page for our template. So we'll go ahead and click add new page. We'll go back to our templates over here, and we need a page that's going to work for our different, for the headline formula that we're going to be presenting. I'll go ahead and choose this template. Again, change everything to our brand colors. And actually halfway through changing things, I realized that I actually want more space. So I'll go ahead and delete these other elements, and I can click and make this one pull up, make out the entire span, and I'll go ahead and just call this Formula One. Change things up a bit, skipping ahead for time purposes, and then because this is a template, it's time to create the fill in the blank portion, right? So we can come over here to elements, and we'll go back to all, and I really like using blocks of shapes to easily show people where they should be filling in the blanks. So the first thing we should do is change the border color of this, so we can change it to something that works. I'd probably play with the color formulas a little more, but here we can come in here, and then we'll give them a place to kind of fill in the blank with whatever they're going to be using. And then drop in the two headline formulas that I could provide in this particular opt-in gift. So what's cool is now I could actually go through and create some other pages explaining how this formula works and how they could apply it to their landing pages or sales presentations. And so when it comes to creating a template, what's awesome is you don't necessarily have to come up with a bunch of different templates or formulas or ideas. You just need one or two that's really going to help them, and then the rest of your opt-in gift can be explaining why they're so important or how to properly use the template or formula that you're providing to them. Now the next one we have on our list is resources. This is going to be number 3. And this is creating a opt-in gift where you're talking about the top X or top Y resources for your particular industry or niche. It could also be a list of contacts or companies that they should be using. So in this example, we're going to be making a opt-in gift that talks about the top, you know, 5 free marketing tools for new marketers, right? So we'll jump back over into Canva here and we will pick another template, and I'll actually scroll down here and play with the marketing proposal template. So we'll go ahead and click, let that load, and now we'll check out some of the templates they have in here to quickly put together our resources list. So we can scroll down and choose one that looks good enough. Let's see this one. Nope, that's not gonna work. Maybe we wanna find one that already has a list put together for us, right? Because that way we don't have to come up with a list for our resources list. Okay, perfect, here we go. So we go ahead, we change this up to whatever your company is, and of course change the colors. We could always drop in a new photo here. I'm going to go a little faster now that you've seen a few examples, and we'd click down here and we'd say our top X resources for achieving Y. And then we'd come in here and we just do numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, something that's cool to spruce this up a little bit is, let's say we're doing this for marketing. I'm going to come back over here to elements, click on graphics, and then I'll search for things like SEO. And pulling graphics to go alongside each one of the numbers. So it's a very quick and easy way to add some nice looking design elements to something which would otherwise just look like a really boring list. So let's say the next one is advertising. We can find one we like, click on it, and of course you can always change the colors of these two. Click and drag, make it nice and small, and then put it next to what advertising would be. And that's how we put together our top resources list. So if you're still getting some value from this video, go ahead and hit that like button. As always, comment below if you have any questions as I continue to go through these. The next one on our list is a worksheet where you're essentially going to be helping someone walk through a process of filling in the blanks. So these last two I'm going to go through relatively quickly here. So we can go back over to Canva and they actually have a worksheet template. So we can click on the worksheet template. Hopefully by now you already know how to create your title page, so we can just scroll through these examples and find a worksheet that works for what we want to do. So I'm just going to click on this one. So here we, of course, we can change all of the colors, we can change the icons here, we can add another page and keep scrolling down until we find one that we think is going to work better for what we're putting together. And this is why I really like using Canva to create worksheets, because of all the templates they have. Really, all you have to do is change the colors and change out some of the icons and you're good to go. Now, the final one we have on our list here is creating an audit. So this is going to be an audit or an assessment. And the reason that you want to put this together is essentially to help someone see what they're missing. So if they're going through their website trying to figure out why their pages aren't ranking, right? You could do an SEO audit checklist, or you could do a workout self-assessment, like what types of workouts are they doing, and then help them figure out why they may or may not be getting the body that they're trying to get. Really, the sky is the limit, and you'd be using the same template, the worksheet template that we just went over for creating that. So thank you for watching. I hope you found this video informative and actionable. If you got some value out of it, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more in-depth tutorials just like this one. Comment below if you have any questions, and as always, keep building the business you love.